Hey, my name is Mike, and I'm going to show you how to create custom survey reports in WordPress. Last week, I showed you my Thrice Cream ice cream shop website, and we learned how to create a survey with some of Formidable Forms' new survey fields. If you'd like to watch that first, just click that card or the link below. We also saw a few of the automatically generated graphs that Formidable Forms gives you for your survey forms. In this video, I want to show you how, with only the tiniest bit more effort, you can make some incredible custom graphs. To save time, we're going to use the same survey that we used last week. However, to show you one more type of report, I went back and added one more question to the survey. It's a drop-down field that asks, "What country are you from?" If you put common questions like this in your own survey, make sure you use the bulk edit options, because I sure as heck am not going to type every country myself. Before we leave, we'll make a note of the field IDs for each of these fields, as we'll need them later. Now, last time we used the reports page to see automatically generated graphs based on our survey entries. This time we're going to make our own graphs on their own page. So we'll create a new page we'll call graphs, and we'll add some shortcode. It may seem scary, but it's really straightforward. I'll explain each piece of shortcode for each graph we make, and I'll have links in the description below to resources so you can make your own. First, we'll start off easy. I want a pie chart of how often the survey respondents come to my shop. So the shortcode starts out with FRM-graph. That just means that we want to create a graph. And then we'll put the ID 96. That's the field ID of the question that asks them how often they come to my shop. The type is a pie chart that we want, so we'll put pie in there. And then I want this graph to take up the entire width of the page, so I'm gonna put width 100%. And then finally, show key equals one. Many of the graphs in Formidable Forms don't default to have the legend of the graph shown, but with this piece of shortcode, the one means we want to see it. Next, we're going to do a cool map chart of where people are from that come to my shop. Once again, it starts out with FRM-graph. And the field ID for that new question I added was 101. The type of this graph is a geo. And then we want the width to be 100% again. And then we're gonna add a color. This is just a shade of blue I liked. When you do this, if you create a geograph, make sure you pick a color. Otherwise, the graph will be across a rainbow gradient of the entire color wheel, and it won't make much sense. Finally, we'll do a graph where we filter the answers of one graph by the answer to another. With this graph, I want to know what my most loyal customers think of my weirdest new possible flavor. So we're going to filter our Likert scale by the how often people come radio button field. FRM-graph, ID 95 was our Likert field. The type is a column, we want a bar graph here. And then we want to filter it by field ID 96, which was the one we used in our pie chart. We only want the answers to show up for the people that chose a few times per week. Those are my most loyal customers. And then we'll change the width to 100 because I want it to take up the whole space of the page. All right, now let's check out the graphs we made. Looking pretty good, right? The legend is here on the pie graph, but if you didn't add the legend, you can still mouse over the sections of the pie to see what each section is for. Our geo map has a light blue gradient since we chose that as our color. And our final graph shows us what our most loyal customers think of our possible new flavors. And isn't that interesting? They really want to try vanilla steak and potatoes. See, this is why making custom reports and graphs for your surveys is important. You can tease out cool insights, like the fact that my most loyal customers want meat-flavored ice cream. Before we finish, let's go back and make our graphs even better. First, let's change our pie graph. I want to put the legend at the top and make the pie graph a donut graph. So I'll add two little things to the first shortcode. So I'm adding legend position equals top, which is pretty self-explanatory, and then pie hole equals 0.5. That makes a hole in the middle of our pie chart, which is a radius of half of the pie chart size. Next, let's change the geo chart. I want the map to show the exact same color for every country, whether one person is from there or 100, as well as get rid of the legend. To do that, we'll also add two little things to the second shortcode. The geotype of graph always graphs a gradient, so if we make the gradient between two of the exact same color, every country will be the same color because there won't be any real gradient. And much like show key equals one made the legend appear for our pie chart, show key equals zero hides it. And finally, our Likert scale bar graph. Something cool about Likert scales is that they're really a collection of multiple fields, and if you want, you can graph just one. I'm going to click Save Draft to save what we've done so far, and then go to the settings of our form. If we go down to our On Submit confirmation message, there are some dots on the top right. Click it, and you can actually see the various field IDs for each part of our Likert scale. In this case, our Vanilla Steak and Potatoes field ID is 99, so we'll take that. We're going to replace our 95 with 99. We'll also delete the width being 100% because that is far too big for one single bar graph. And now let's check out the changes we made. Looks great. There's our pie hole with a legend on top. Our geomap only has one color with no legend. And our bar chart only graphs the vanilla steak and potatoes. And that is just a few of the awesome things you can do with custom graphs in Formidable Forms. Subscribe to see more WordPress tips, and I'll see you next time.